We notice that recovery and discovery of large volume of illegal drugs usually happens in Region 3. Even the 990 kilograms of shabu that was investigated here in Congress and Senate allegedly came from this region. Just like the 3.6 billion and 1.3 billion worth of shabu that was seized and discovered recently in Mexico and Mabalacat, Pampanga, respectively. Mr. Chair, tanong lamang po sa PDEA. PDEA, sir, do you agree in my observation?
Yes, Your Honor.
Bakit po kaya?
Maybe a factor to consider, Your Honor, is that Region 3 is a very near National Capital Region. It has seaports, airports, expressways, and so the mode of travel, at the same time, the mode of bringing in these illicit drugs is suited to the situation in Region 3, Your Honor.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chair. Hindi po ba natin naisip na base po dito sa recent investigations and operations ng concerned agencies, parang itong Subic Bay Pre-Fort Zone ang nagagamit para sa pagpasok ng mga illegal drugs? Kasi po, ang dami po ninyong nabanggit, Mr. Chair, ang daming nabanggit ng PDEA. Do you agree, PDEA, sir, na base po dito sa mga result ng inyong operations, pwede ba natin sabihin na itong mga illegal drugs na pumapasok sa ating bansa ay dito talaga dumadaan? Kung hindi lahat, most of these illegal drugs, dito po pumapasok sa Subic Bay Pre-Fort Zone?
No, Your Honor. Because there are also possibilities that there is a high incidence of drugs are being shipped into. Like, for example, in Region 7, Cagayan de Oro also. So, it's I do not have enough data to support that all or most of the illegal drugs are being shipped to Subic Port, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, yung po bang nabanggit sa Region 7 and Cagayan de Oro, malaki po ba yung volume ng shabu?
If we base on history, sir, even during the past administration, there has been large shipments of illegal drugs seized in Region 7, sir.
Mr. Chair, more or less ilang kilograms po?
I do not have the figures with me right now, Your Honor, but I can provide the committee with this data.
Kasi po, Mr. Chair, mahalaga po na malaman natin ang volume kasi siyempre po, as operatives, as agency concerned anti-illegal drugs, importante po na mas priority natin yung volume. Anyway, Mr. Chair, my second adverse observation is based on House Resolution Number 1346 introduced by Honorable Representative Aurelio Dong Gonzalez and Honorable Representative Robert Ace Barbers, and House Resolution Number 1351 introduced by Honorable Representative Jefferson J. Conghon, the recent seized and discovered illegal drugs were delivered to Subic Bay Pre-Fort Zone on September 18, 2020, on board of SITC Shoko Shipping Lines. PDEA, Mr. Chair, considering that the said contraband were delivered on board SITC Shoko, have you identified the suspects involved in the said shipment?
Your Honor, may I ask that the National Bureau of Investigation, being the project initiator, be asked on this question, Your Honor?
Mr. Chair, may we ask NBI kung may na-identify po silang suspects, particularly yung mga personnel or management from SITC Shoko?
Mr. Chair, good morning, Your Honor. Inasmuch as we would like to answer it now, maybe we will be requesting an executive session later on for these questions to be answered since the case is undergoing investigation, Papa. Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you, NBI. Mr. Chair, thank you. Third observation, Mr. Chair. On the operations conducted by NBI Manila Task Force against illegal drugs in the PNP Mabalacat City, Pampanga, on August 26, 2023, the motor vehicle loaded with 200 kilograms of suspected shabu was reportedly abandoned at a parking lot of a supermarket in Barangay Mabiga, Mabalacat City, Pampanga. Mr. Chair, pwede po bang malaman sa NBI Manila? Do you agree that your operations was burned out, nasunog, that resulted to the abandonment of said vehicle loaded with 200 kilograms of shabu?
No, sir.
So kung hindi po, ano po ang dahilan at na-abandon yung sasakyan? Dahil wala po yan eh. Siguro, primarily, intentional, in-abandon eh. Alam naman natin na kung tayo ang possessor ng drugs, eh malaking halaga yun eh. Naturalmente, iingatan natin. So kung hindi po agree ang NBI Manila, ano po ang nakikita nating dahilan at inabandon yung sasakyan na may malaking volume of shabu? Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chairman, the vehicle was abandoned 6 days already when the NBI was called to inspect the vehicle.
Again, Mr. Chair, wala po kayong idea or lead bakit inabandon yung sasakyan samantalang malaki pong halaga ng shabu at nandoon? Wala po ba tayong idea, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, according to the informant, no, the driver felt that he was being followed by a law enforcement agency. So he decided to park the vehicle in the mall and he just abandoned it, no? Just ran away.
Mr. Chair, considering na inabandon yung subject vehicle, paano po ninyo nalaman na mayroong abandoned vehicle doon sa supermarket na yon, loaded with more or less 200 kilograms of shabu?
Mr. Chairman, it was called to us by the security guards of the mall.
So, Mr. Chair, nabanggit po 6 days ago na abandon yung sasakyan. Saan po ba tumawag yung sinasabi nating security personnel? Is it sa NBI or sa police of Mabalacat City?
Mr. Chairman, according to the security officers of the mall, they already reported that to the police. But we do not know what the police officers at the area did on the report, but we just acted on that information provided by the security officers of the mall.
So ano po bang nangyari kung ang personnel ng security ay tumawag sa police station ng Mabalacat City? Yung po bang Mabalacat ang then after that, yung Mabalacat police personnel concern or the chief of police, yung po ba ang tumawag sa NBI para nagkaroon po ng operations na nagresulta sa recovery ng 200 kilograms of shabu, Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chairman, the police Mabalacat did not call NBI. It was the security officers of the mall who informed us, who just provided us with an information that an abandoned vehicle at the mall was there.
Mr. Chair, clarify ko lang. Sabi po, ang security personnel ng supermarket ang nag-report. Ang tanong po, saan ba siya nag-report? Sa police or sa NBI?
According to them, they first reported it to the police. No.
Then after that,
after 6 days, they reported that to us.
So, meaning, Mr. Chair, after na ma-report sa police, hindi sila kumilos, hindi sila gumalaw, then after 6 days, kapal sila nag-coordinate or tumawag sa NBI, then doon parang nagkaroon ng joint operation. Tapa po ba, NBI? Mr. Chair?
So after 6 days, when the matter was reported to us, the NBI proceeded to Mabalacat, Pampanga, Mr. Chairman.
So, Mr. Chair, very clear na after 6 days, doon pa lang nagkaroon ng action to address this abandoned vehicle. Tama po ba, NBI, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair, nandito po ba yung Chief of Police ng Mabalacat City? PNP.
Yes, we invited the Chief of Police. Nandito si ang Chief of Police ng Mabalacat. Yeah. Can you please occupy the seat in front?
Mr. Chair, Chief of Police. Do you agree doon sa nabanggit po ng NBI na ang security personnel ng supermarket ang nag-report sa police station na sinasabing may abandoned vehicle doon sa supermarket?
Yes, sir.
Ano po ang date noon?
August 25, sir, in my recollection, according to the blotters ng Mabalacat City Police Station, sir.
Mr. Chair, after na ma-report po sa inyo na August 25,
sir, yung coordination.
No, please. Kailan po ni-report sa inyo ng security personnel ng supermarket na mayroong abandoned vehicle?
I think August 20, sir. August 20.
Hindi po tayo sigurado.
Allow me, sir, to review my reference, sir.
Mr. And, Chair?
An apology, sir. The Chief of Police on that date, sir, is Police Lieutenant Colonel Abraham Abayari, and I assume the post September 22, 2023, sir.
Mr. Chair, with all due respect, I think hindi po siya dapat ang sasagot doon sa ating mga clarificatory questions. Baka po magkaroon lamang ng problema kung siya ang sasagot. Mr. Chair, na-invite po ba yung Chief of Police during the time na nagkaroon ng ganitong incident?
Comsec, did we invite the Chief of Police at that time when the abandoned vehicle was discovered? So, hindi kayo ang Chief of Police that time?
Hindi pa po, sir.
So, I'm sure, but merong reports yan, di ba?
Meron, sir. Meron.
So, anong naka-blatter sa inyo? Ano yung nakalagay sa report nyo? When was the information given to the Chief of Police regarding an abandoned vehicle dyan sa parking lot?
Sir, based on the blatter, sir, only... August 20, sir, Sunday morning, na tumawag, sir, ang security guard ng SM Hypermarket sa CTOC, sir, na Mabalacat CPS, informing that a Toyota Avanza red in color bearing plate number CGS643 was abandoned on their parking lot since August 19, 2023 night until the pag-report nila, sir.
Does that satisfy Congressman Busita?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Meron na po ang follow-up question.
Last question, Congressman Busita.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Kung August 20 na-report sa police station yung abandoned vehicle, Mr. Chair, kailan po naman nag-report? Or ano po yung kanilang action taken after they received said report?
Sir, based dito po sa report, August 21, CTOC Mabalacat, receiving a phone call from SM Market security regarding reported abandoned vehicle served by Corporal Suleiman immediately relate the same to Patrolman Panilagaw for investigation, sir?
If I may add a question, Mr. Chair.
Can I wrap up?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you.
Last question, Mr. Chair. Mabalacat City Police Station representative, kailan po ninyo ni-report sa NBI itong abandoned vehicle? At sinasabi po ng NBI, 6 days bago na-report sa kanila. Again, Mr. Chair, representative from Mabalacat City Police Station, kailan po ni-report itong incident sa NBI para nagkaroon ng joint operations?
Well, sir, wala pong nangyaring report sa ano sa NBI. Hindi po ni-report. Hindi po ni-report or in-inform, sir.
Mr. Chair, with your indulgence, gusto ko lang matuldukan. Sinabi po ng NBI 6 days after na ma-report, saka pa lang sila nagkaroon ng joint operations. But allegedly, sinasabi po ng representative of Mabalacat City Police Station, walang report na nangyaring ganon. Balikan ko lang, Mr. Chair, with your permission, yung NBI. NBI, sir, saan po galing yung sinasabi ninyo na after 6 days, doon pa lang na-report sa inyo? And based on that report, saka pa lang po kayo nagkaroon ng joint operations, NBI, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chairman, to clarify, no? After 6 days, tinawag po sa amin yan sa NBI nung security officer ng supermarket. It's the supermarket security guards, not the police who called the NBI, Mr. Chairman.
So, Mr. Chair, very clear na pala. Nag-report ang security personnel sa police station ng Mabalacat City on August 20, 2023. Unfortunately, siguro nakita po nung security personnel ng supermarket na walang ginagawa ang police station. Then, tumawag sila sa NBI. Then, after that, doon pa lang nagkaroon ng operation. And siyempre, as standard operating procedure, nag-coordinate ang NBI po sa Mabalacat City Police Station. Kaya po nagkaroon ng joint operation. And na-recover po nila yung abandoned vehicle loaded with 200 kilograms of shabu. Yun lamang po, Mr. Chair. Maraming salamat po.